Hey everybody, hope you guys had a great day. Today we're going to talk about Marvel's Avengers. We're going to talk about the recent blog post that Square Enix and Crystal Dynamics put out, and of course, some clarification about this whole thing. So with that, let's get started and talk about how Marvel's Avengers will always be a failure. Well, according to the blog post, there was a cosmetic and XP rework, and let's talk about the XP rework here. They begin by saying, since we launched last September, our balance team has been evaluating the XP curve for leveling from 1 to 50. We'll be making some changes to address the two core issues. The current XP curve isn't really a curve at all. In most RPGs, the amount of XP you need to level up increases as you gain levels in a curve. But in our systems, it's a straight line. Now, already off the bat, that is incredibly wrong. As someone who plays a lot of MMOs and a lot of RPGs, even JRPGs, you don't level up in a curve. You, in fact, do level up in a line. The amount of experience needed compared to the amount of XP you gain should be determined by the type of enemies that you are fighting and their level, and then the amount of XP gained from each of those enemies. There is never such a thing as an actual curve of experience that you're given. You're always given a straight line. If your game is designed well, and if it is paced well, then in fact, the enemies you are fighting give the right amount of XP to keep you at a steady pace across that straight line of, because once you get to the top, that is when you start to get into the end game content. Of course, that's how pretty much every MMO, ARPG, Diablo-like, etc. is designed. So having them say it's a curve is already completely incorrect, in my opinion. So let's see what else they have to say. This has led to pacing issues. Ah, I guess I'm right already. Such as skill points currently being rewarded too fast, which may be confusing and overwhelming to new players. That is insane. Marvel's Avengers is probably one of the easiest games to play, has the most basic bare bones RPG mechanics, and is very Destiny-like. Nothing about that game is confusing for any player across any sort of scope. So we're already into the liar, liar, pants on fire scenario. We want each decision to invest in a skill or heroic to be more meaningful. Well, then if that's the case, the skills and abilities that you invest in your heroics should in fact be meaningful, not dumbed down, watered down, fake RPG points. But hey, who am I, right? Based on these issues, we will be increasing the amount of XP needed to level up. Oh, we're inflating a grind. Starting from around level 25. Wait, so they're going to increase the amount of XP needed once you hit level 25? So you're getting stronger as you play. You're enjoying the game because you're getting stronger. Then when you hit level 25, they're going to artificially inflate the amount of experience needed. So that way the game you're playing takes longer to actually level up and find anything meaningful in the first place. And now instead of actually creating new mechanics, new skills, new abilities, or adjusting them accordingly by having them become more meaningful in that way, no. We're going to reduce the amount of times you actually get to level up, make it last longer, and therefore you get to have it experienced that way because you're going to be spending more time doing it. Isn't that so much more fun? Now, of course, they say this amount will increase the closer you get to level 50 so that it will take longer to reach higher levels. Great, and will only affect character level, not power level. If you have already level 50 characters, which is the current maximum, this won't affect you. If you have a character who isn't level 50 and want to speed up their progress, take this time to do so before the update on March 18th. Ah, yes. Make sure you do it now. This honestly isn't going to be beneficial for the game at all. And in fact, apparently they had to make a Reddit post for clarification. Let's take a look at that now. So here it is, more clarification and details on the recently announced XP change. We wanted to offer more clarification and details on the recently announced XP change. We did not change XP to increase grind for grind's sake. No, you literally did. That's exactly what you did. Our initial blog was not comprehensive enough to convey what we were doing and why, so we caused confusion. We get it. No, you clearly don't get it, because you do not know how to design a game. This is what you killed Deus Ex for. Thanks. So what are we doing and why? Currently, as you get to higher levels, the XP acquired between levels didn't scale well, but your ability to crush enemies certainly does speed up at higher levels. So you could end up leveling up dinging, ah yes, the MMO ding ding, 2 to 3 times per mission, with missions taking about 10 to 20 minutes in length. So what's the problem? This is great, you might say. The problem we were seeing and hearing was that you would immediately get more skill points than you had time to review, apply, and get used to before embarking on your next mission and gaining the next few levels. Hopefully you can see the issue here. No, there is no issue. None whatsoever. Because the whole point of any service game or the whole point of any online game is to get to the end to then experience the content. The leveling up is not the actual end game. The leveling up is the beginning of the game. As someone who's played World of Warcraft quite recently and quite often for the last, 20 or so years, the game doesn't actually begin until you hit level 60. Then you start understanding what the game has to offer and the end game that it provides. Same thing with Diablo. The game doesn't end when you level up or when you reach max level. The game ends when you are doing bail runs and finding out the gear, picking out your items, your equipment, your stats, all that good stuff across the board. But let's continue. We want people to level up. In fact, we really want to see more people level up more heroes, as playing the full Avenger roster should be the most fun thing you can do. But we don't want leveling up experience to be too overwhelming or diminish exploring each skill purchase. Look, I guarantee you, every person who picks a character is going to go onto Google and type out Iron Man skill tree best build. And they're just going to follow that build. Or they're going to type out Black Widow best skill tree build or Captain America best shield build. That's all they're going to do. And they're going to follow whatever the actual meta of the game in fact is that is done by theory crafting and then do it that way. They're not going to think about like, I wonder which point is going to impact me the most. And even if they did, they can just wait till the end of the mission and then review everything that way and then play the game like normal and say, okay, this seems kind of cool. Let's try that. But no, instead you're artificially going to deflate the amount of experience people gain. You're going to inflate the amount of time it takes for them to level up. So that way it feels more meaningful. Ah yes, you guys really got this in the bag. So we smoothed out the higher level curves so we can make it less likely to ding more than once or twice per mission at the higher end. There is so much more variability in how quick you gain XP. You know what, there's really nothing in here that's going to be anything capable of what they're saying. They just keep talking about dinging, making levels at a steadier pace every 2 to 4 missions on the upper end. The problem is with this game and with any live service game, the issue isn't how long it takes you to level. The issue is what is at the end game. What kind of content do you have at the end of the game for me to continuously do that is fun, exciting, or want me to be repetitive for it? Just like in Diablo, just like in Warcraft, just like in every other MMO that is successful. The whole point is not leveling up. The whole point is getting to max level and playing out what you have designed at the end for me to do once I have reached max level. This sort of theory, idea, and design of video games as services is the problem with so many live service games going the wrong route. They don't understand what people actually want to do. People grind through levels continuously to get to the end game content. They don't enjoy leveling. Leveling is called a grind for a reason. You are grinding through it. It is not fun. It is monotonous. It is boring. That's why it's called a grind. That's the whole point of it. You're literally deflating your own argument by calling it a grind in the game. But yet, we have the simplest post, 3 sentences, made by 1 Reddit poster, destroying the entire argument that they're trying to make. Let's read that. This is a terrible move. Leveling up was never the issue. The lack of content was. 635 updutes. Again, this is someone who's played multiple ARPGs, MMOs, and RPGs throughout his entire life. The grind is not something that you want to increase. In fact, you want to make the grind become brisk and fun as much as you can by varying the content between everything else that you're doing in the game or making it feel like you're not even grinding at all. That's the whole point. But when you're trying to artificially inflate the amount of time it takes for a grind to occur or a level to occur, delaying the amount of time someone can get to max level to experience the content that you should have had designed for the end game, that becomes a problem. Because you see, the whole point of these kinds of games is to get to the end game, to get the best gear, to get all that extra stuff, to see the extra content you've designed besides just the leveling experience. You're doing this backwards. And that is why Marvel Avengers will always be a failure. And this is what you killed Deus Ex for. This is what we now get. We get an artificially inflated grind on a game that no one wants to play because it's boring and there's no endgame. Thank you so very much. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. I really do appreciate it. If you like the content and you like the video, please subscribe. It does mean a lot. If you want to check me out on other places, you can follow me on Twitch and Twitter. It's at Oh No, It's Alex. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Do you think this is a good idea? Do you think it's a bad idea? You know what? I want to get your feedback on this one because it looks like it's going to be bad across the board. Anyways, if you also want Discord access, become a YouTube member or Twitch subscriber, and I'll send you guys the link there. Hope you guys have a great one, and I'll see you guys next time.
Fucking bullshit! Son of a bitch! Bullshit, Joe Hogan!